Hello young doctors, today in this video I'll be discussing about the NEET 2019 biology paper, how it will be. And as you know that NCERT is the bible for biology part, and this time in 2019 the paper is prepared by NTA and not NCERT. So the pattern will be more or less similar. But let's see in detail the expected pattern of NEET paper 2019 and previous year AIIMS and NEET paper biology paper analysis, and how to score more than 340 out of 360 in NEET biology with 5 months of preparation, and last 3 to 4 months strategies to follow, that is what the toppers follow and what is the strategy of a topper should be to score more than 340 out of 360 in NEET biology part. And this is brought to you by AIM/NEET, and I am Dr. Ajay Mohan. I completed my MBBS from AIIMS Delhi. So let's see in detail what is the mark distribution or the number of questions that will be asked from a particular chapter. As you already know that in NEET, around 55% of the questions will be from 12th standard and 45% of the questions will be from 11th standard. Almost equal weightage, plus more will be from 12th standard portions. So let's see, this is the Bible that you should be following, Biology NCERT. This should be a basic book, and after following the theory, you should be following the MCQs from any guidebooks. I will preferably say Biology Gear Up. I have prepared the book and I have added many expected questions for NTA 2019 and NEET 2019 exam. So please follow the book or share it with your friends, and try to do the MCQs after completing a particular chapter. And also in those chapters I have added NCERT crisp notes, which you should be following at least twice or thrice, revise it again and again, because those are prepared with analysis from previous year papers, that is 31 years of NEET paper and also 20 years of AIIMS paper. So that is mentioned, given in a crisp note, so that you can follow it very easily and revise it again and again. And if any question is asked, you are not liable to make mistakes, because almost all the toppers make all those questions right. So your AIIMS should be more than 340 out of 360 in your biology. So this should be your basic book, and after that do MCQs from Biology Gear Up. So let's see what is the mark distribution or the number of questions asked from biology part from class 12th. So reproduction organisms, one question will be asked. Sexual reproduction in flowering plants, 4 questions will be asked. This is really important. Human reproduction and reproductive health together, 6 questions will be asked. Principles of inheritance and variation, molecular basis of inheritance. Total, there will be 9 questions, that is from the single chapter genetics, single part genetics. Evolution, usually 3 to 4 questions will be asked. Human health and diseases, 3 questions will be asked, and that will be very easy. Strategies for enhancement in food production, 2 questions will be asked, same very easy questions. Microbes in human welfare, 2 questions. Biotechnology, both included, 5 questions will be asked. That is biotechnology as a whole, 5 questions will be asked. So as a whole, biotechnology part comprises of 4 chapters: strategies, microbes, biotechnology principles and its applications. Total 9 questions you can expect for NEET 2019, and this is more or less same for AIIMS also. The number of questions may vary, but the percentage distribution is almost similar. So next part is actually the most boring part of NCERT. Most students find it very boring to read those chapters, but those chapters are very important, because almost 12 questions from this ecology part will be asked. Organism and population, ecosystem, biodiversity and environmental issues together comprises 12 questions. So this is all about the plus two part of biology. So let's see about the plus one part. So this is a biology textbook that you should be following, NCERT. After reading a particular chapter, do MCQs from NCERT Gear Up. So these two books, you'll be able to score more than 340 out of 360 for your biology paper. 5% of the questions will be outside NCERT. Every year around 4 to 5 questions are outside NCERT, and those questions are also included in NCERT Gear Up. So 100% correct answers you will be able to give if you're following these two books very thoroughly. So let's see about plus one question distribution. Living world, one question will be asked, very easy question. 4 questions for biological classification, 3 questions from plant kingdom, and 4 questions from animal kingdom. These 3 chapters, there are many terms, the classification is a bit difficult, but once you have grasped the concept, then you will be able to get the 11 questions right. Morphology of flowering plants, 4 questions. Anatomy of flowering plants, 3 questions. Structural organization in animals, 2 questions. You can expect at least 1 or 2 image-based questions. And cell, the unit of life, 5 questions. This is really important. Cytology part carries 9 questions in total. 9 questions in total. And the cytology part includes cell, the unit of life, biomolecules, and also cell division. Okay. And there comes the plus two most boring chapters. That is transport in plants, mineral nutrition, photosynthesis, respiration, plant growth and development. Very easy questions are asked, and you'll be able to score 95% of it right if you are reading it at least 3 to 4 times. And don't forget to follow the MCQs also. One question will be asked from transport, 2 questions from mineral nutrition, plus or minus. Photosynthesis, 2 questions will be asked. That will be a bit on the tougher side. Respiration, there will be calculation, there will be 1 or at time 0 questions will be asked. Plant growth and development, around 2 questions will be asked. So this is the most important part of biology. The human physiology part, that comprises total around 15 questions, 2 from digestion, breathing 2, body fluids 2, excretion 1 or 0, locomotion 2, neural control 3, and chemical coordination 3 questions. And you can expect most of the image-based questions from this particular chapter. So this is in short the analysis of the 31, after analyzing 31 years NEET paper and 20 years AIIMS paper. So this is the trend that we can expect in NTA 2019 exam in the biology part. And if you are following it really thoroughly for the next 5 months, you will be easily able to score more than 340 out of 360, and you can grab a top rank, that is top 100 rank, and get a seat of your choice and join the college of your dream and pursue your MBBS course. So some students have asked, what are the books that I should be following to score more than 340 out of 360 in NEET and AIIMS? So as I told you, if we take the whole paper, let's analyze it. Analyzing the whole paper, you can see that 90 questions are there. 45 questions from botany and 45 questions from zoology. 55% of the questions will be asked from plus two part, and 45% of the questions will be asked from plus one part. So more or less similar, but more weightage will be for plus two part. And in those questions, 90 questions, around 90% of those questions will be, the topics will be repeated or topics will be same. Those topics have been asked before in AIIMS or NEET exam, and same topic will be asked, but different question from the same topic will be modified and asked. And there'll be repeat questions, which decides the rank. That is, there'll be indirect repeats and there'll be direct repeats. Direct repeats is direct same to same question will be asked, and that will comprise around 10 to 20% of the AIIMS paper, AIIMS or NEET paper. And indirect repeats will be around 50 to 60%. Almost the whole chunk of the paper will be indirect repeats, 50 to 60%. And those repeats, how are they prepared? The topic will be same. The question will be a bit modified, or the question will be a bit different from which have been asked in the previous years. But the concept will be same. The portion of NCERT which you should read that particular concept will be same. So this is the best book to follow your 31 years NEET, because you are having page wise reference for all the questions. The most important part of this book is that page wise reference from NCERT. So if you are following a particular question, if you are not able to get the clear concept, just go back. There is a reference page number of that particular page from NCERT biology. So you can go to that, read at least one paragraph before or one paragraph below that particular concept, because the next indirect repeat or the modified version of the question which have been asked before will be from that particular topic, but a different concept will be asked. So this is the importance of page wise reference. You can go to that particular page and read that part again and again, because any question which is going to get repeated, you are not liable to make any mistake. And those students who have been prepared very well in their institute days, just go through this book, Biology Gear Up. I prepared it, and there is NCERT crisp notes. Just follow that really well, and that is prepared after analysis of 31 years NEET paper and 20 years AIIMS paper. So very crisp notes, and obviously after following the theory from your NCERT book, make sure you practice more and more MCQs, because MCQs are asked in your exam, not theory based questions like in your board exam. So you should be comfortable with your MCQ part. Practice it again and again. The MCQs are arranged in level wise in this textbook, NCERT Biology Gear Up, level 1, 2, 3 and 4. After completing your chapter, go through level 1 first. Then after completing that, do level 2, level 3 and level 4. After completing all the levels, you are proficient enough and you are able to score at least 85% to 90% in your main exam. So this is all about the biology part. I'll be analyzing physics and chemistry part in the upcoming videos also. So if you like the video, please like, subscribe and share with your friends, and follow AIIM4AIIMS/NEET for more videos. Thank you.